In this video, we're going to finish the graphing systems of inequalities worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Picking up where we left off with number 5, I'll quickly go over the directions. We're going to plot each of the inequality lines, shade in the appropriate side, and where those shaded regions intersect, that is our solution. Just like in graphing systems of equalities or systems of equations, the intersection is the answer, which is one point for an equation, but for an inequality, it is multiple points, hence the shaded region. So in number 5, looking at this first inequality, the slope m is negative 5 halves, and the y-intercept b is negative 2. So we'll plot 0, negative 2, and then using our slope, negative 5 halves, we'll find the next point that falls on that line. So negative 5 over 2, going down 5 will put us off of the graph, however going up 5 and 2 in the negative direction for x, so positive 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the y, and then negative 1, negative 2, which is still equal to negative 5 halves. For the slope, that's our other point, so at point negative 2, 3. Now because this is less than or equal to, the points will be connected with a solid line. Now let's use our test point of 0, 0 to figure out which side we're going to shade to the right of that solid line or to the left. If we plug 0 in for y and 0 in for x, we'll have 0 is less than or equal to negative 5 halves times 0 minus 2, which will be 0 is less than or equal to negative 2, which is not true. So we're going to be shading in to the side opposite that 0, 0 point, which is to the left. Now, for our next line, we're going to use a slope m of negative 1 half, and we're going to use a y-intercept b of a positive 2. So plotting 0, 2, and then using our slope, negative 1 over positive 2, or positive 1 over negative 2. I'll use the former, so going down 1 in the y direction, negative 1, and positive 2 in the x direction, we'll reach the point 2, 1. Now because this is less than, not less than or equal to, we're going to connect those with a dashed line. And the reason for the dashed line is because any point that falls on that line does not make the inequality true. However, if it was less than or equal to, then falling on that line would hold true for the inequality. But now let's figure out which way we're going to shade. Using our test point of 0, 0, plugging 0 in for y and 0 in for x, we'll have 0 is less than negative 1 half times 0 plus 2, which is 0 is less than 2. That is indeed true, so we're going to be shading into the region that contains the point 0, 0, which is below that dashed line. Now the area in which those shaded regions intersect is part of our answer, which, making sure this line is extended out a little more, occurs here. So there is our answer in number 5. So essentially we can pick any point within this shaded region, such as negative 3, 0, and that will hold true for both of these inequalities. Moving on to number 6, our slope m is 2/3 for the first inequality, and for the second inequality, that slope is negative 4/3. The y-intercept in our first inequality is a positive 3, and the y-intercept in our second inequality is a negative 3. So starting with that first inequality, we'll plot 0, positive 3, the y-intercept, and then using that slope of positive 2, 3, we'll go up 2 and over 3 to the right to get to our next point of 3, 5, and because that's greater than or equal to, we'll connect those with a solid line. Now let's use our test point of 0, 0 to see which way we're going to shade. Plugging 0 in for y and 0 in for x, 2/3 times 0 will cancel out. 0 is greater than or equal to 3 is not true. Therefore, we're going to shade in the region that does not contain that point 0, 0, which is above the line. Now for our next inequality, the y-intercept was 0, negative 3. and the slope is negative 4 over 3 or 4 over negative 3. So going positive 4 in the y direction and negative 3 in the x direction will be at that point negative 3, 1, which also happens to fall on our previous inequality line. Now this one is greater than, not greater than or equal to, so we'll connect those with a dashed line. Now we can use our test point of 0, 0 to see if we're going to shade to the right of the line or to the left of the line. Plugging 0 in for y and 0 in for x in that second inequality, negative 4 thirds times 0 is 0, we have that 0 is greater than negative 3, which is true. So we're going to be shading to the right of that line where it contains the point 0, 0. And where those intersect, that will be our solution. So there's our solution in number 6. In number 7, in order to get this in the form of y equals mx plus b, we're going to have to subtract 4x from that first. So we'll have that y is less than negative 4x plus 2. So the slope of the first line, m, is negative 4, which we can write as negative 4 over 1, or 1 over negative 4, and our y-intercept b is a positive 2. So graphing that first inequality, 0, 2, and then using our slope to graph that next point, we'll go down 4 and 1 to the right in the positive x direction. Now because this is less than, we're going to connect those two points with a dashed line. Now, I rewrote this in the form of y equals mx plus b in order to use the slope to plot my next point. However, you do not necessarily have to rewrite this. You could use a t-table, an xy t-table, and plug in points for x and solve for y. However, I think it's easier using slope to plot my next point. So now we're going to use our test point of 0, 0, since it does not follow on that dashed line, to see which side we're going to shade to, either to the left of that dashed line or to the right. Plugging in 0 for y, we'll have 0 is less than negative 4, plugging in 0 for x, times 0 plus 2. So that's 0 is less than 2, which is indeed true. So we're going to be shading to the left of that line, since that holds true. Now, for our next inequality, y is greater than negative 2. That means whatever x value we have, y is always negative 2. So if we have an x value of negative 4, y is negative 2. If we have an x value of positive 3, y is negative 2. So you can see that this is going to form a horizontal line, and because it's greater than, it's going to be a dashed horizontal line. Using the test point of 0, 0, if I plug 0 in for y, 0 is indeed greater than negative 2, so I'm going to be shading above this line. And where those shaded regions intersect, that is my answer. So that's my solution in number 7. And lastly in this video, and for this worksheet, I'll go over number 8. If you haven't done so already, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now that you've hopefully done that, let's go over number 8. We need to rewrite each of these inequalities in the form of y equals mx plus b in order to graph. So for the first inequality, we'll subtract 3x from both sides. In doing so, we'll get that 2y is greater than or equal to negative 3x minus 2. Now I'm going to need to divide both sides by 2 in order to get y all by itself. So I'll have y is greater than or equal to negative 3 halves x minus 2 divided by 2, which is 1. So rewriting this inequality, I have y is greater than or equal to negative 3 halves x minus 1. Now let's look at x plus 2y is less than or equal to 2. I'll start by subtracting x from both sides, so I'll get that 2y is less than or equal to negative x plus 2. And when I divide both sides by 2, I'll get that y is less than or equal to negative 1 half x plus 2 divided by 2, which is 1. So rewriting that inequality below, I'll have y is less than or equal to -1/2 x + 1. Now my slope for the first inequality, m, is -3/2, and my y-intercept b is -1. So I'll plot that, 0, -1, and going down 3 and over 2 to the right, I'll get to the point 2, -4, which is another point on that line, and that line is solid since it's greater than or equal to. Now using my test point of 0, 0, I'll figure out if I need to shade to the right of that line or to the left of the line. Plugging in 0 in for y and 0 in for x, -3/2 times 0 is 0, so I'll get 0 is greater than or equal to -1, which is indeed true. So I'm going to be shading to the right of that line where it contains the point 0, 0. Now for my second inequality, y is less than or equal to -1/2 x + 1, my slope m is -1/2, and my y-intercept value b is a positive 1. So plotting 0, 1, and using my slope going down 1 and 2 to the right, I'll be at point 2, 0. And since it's less than or equal to, that's a solid line. Now I need to figure out which side I need to shade to. I can still use that test point of 0, 0, so plugging 0 in for y, I'll get 0 is less than or equal to -1/2 × 0 + 1. So that will give me that 0 is less than or equal to 1. So I do indeed shade below that line where it contains the point 0, 0. And my intersection of shaded regions is my solution. So there is my answer in number 8. I can pick any point within that shaded region or on either of these solid lines below the intersection point of the lines that connect to that shaded region, and those will hold true for both of my inequalities. If you didn't do so before number 8, remember to click that like button and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any comments, leave them below.